My topic is, I say again, recirculating aquaculture system and overview. I'd like to give my overview with several topics. First, I will mention about aquaculture, what kind of aquaculture dealing with different environment, and basic principle of the RAS and the pros and cons of the RAS, and recent development in RAS technology. And last one is the current RAS implementation in the world. I will give some example of this interesting topic. As you know, fisheries and the aquaculture is one of the very important source of the protein for human being. But more recently, the fisheries stock is the more or less stable, but the aquaculture going to increase. So all over the world, almost 600 species are in aquaculture, it's reached to more than 400 million tons. So let me move to more detail. As you see, mainly finfish aquaculture, but also mollusks, crustacean, amphibians, invertebrates, and algae also cultured, and the human being used this the other species as well. So the other group, biggest one is the finfish. So let me what kind of system we use make it this aquaculture? Water based and land based. The water based, as you see, there is a restocking or stock enhancement, let's say sea rinsing, cage aquaculture, or depend on the place depends, inshore and offshore. And land based system, we can see the some rain fit ponds, float rod system, tanks and raceway, and recirculate system. Let's go to and see the more detail of this system. I will show you the nice, for example, this is the one of the picture from our restocking activity during the ADC turbot the course. This is the sea rinsing or restocking. Make aquaculture in the fishery and you develop the seed production. And if the fish size get a certain the size, it depends on the species, you can release it. So it's going to increase and then you can catch again. So this is the, we say, the restocking or stock enhancement. This is a cage culture. One of the examples in the Black Sea aquaculture. And this is the more wider in the Mediterranean area. So this is one of the peak growth percent of the region. This is the freshwater cage. Depending on the place, this is the one of the dam lake in Turkey. You can see that now it's increased really the big percent of the aquaculture in Turkey. So there's the opportunity to make aquaculture in the dam lake. Of course, those are, they have some difficulties. So why I mentioned about that kind of this is the pond aquaculture system. All of them depend on the natural sources, depend on the what water is available, which places the water available, you must go there. But for the recirculated system, it's not the same. For the pond is also, there is some limitation even if the some small ponds in area. Let's compare this system. Pond system, float row system. Those are the land-based culture system. You need almost 20 to 40 cubic meter of water to get 1 kilogram fish. So it means that you use the high amount of water. Then typically you used to grow fry to fingerlings. Of course, you need some chemical to treat some problem. And it's not the intensive system. So, depend on the places, in some countries, this technique. Float row system, the less water used per kilogram fish. It's about 5 cubic meter of water. We say less, but still it's a high amount. And there is a different type of the pond or shape is different. And you need constant flow, clean water. It's necessary. Let's move to raceway system. This is our topic. Raceway is a novel technology which reuses water for pasture of aquatic animals. Use the same water, almost 90-95%. So just several percent need to renew. Of course, to reuse this water, based on removed waste and restored water quality. So during my presentation, I will mention about more deeply on each topic. One of the land-based culture system depends on the aim, different scale for the experimental scale or pilot scale or industrial scale. It's depend on the aim. You can see the many of this the example. As you remember, I said that in the flow system, you need 5 cubic meter per kilogram fish. But in here, 1 cubic of water can support 80 kilogram fish. So to grow 1 kilogram fish, you need a small amount of water, just a few. So water used to produce per kilogram fish decreasing by RAS 30 cubic meter to 0.2 cubic meter, almost 100 times less. Let's see, the open used to high amount water, low level RAS, and intensive RAS and super intensive RAS, depend on your aim. Total biomass, recovered fish, and recovered oxygen is one of the important points. To what to consider. When investigating in RAS, the needs of PPA must be considered for designing and engineering the system. So, what kind of RAS you mentioned about? There are big variation in terms of size. In your house, the small aquarium is the RAS. But if you go to some the big aquarium, in some countries, the million cubic meter, several million cubic meter. It's also RAS. Footprint, biosecurity is very important. Higher flexibility to size selection. As I mentioned before, for cage culture or pond culture, all of them, you must go to site which the water exists. But in this case, you have a flexibility to site selection. Let me explain to component of the RAS. I will give the 6 different section of my presentation in terms of the RAS component. So first one, the fish tanks, what kind of tanks? And the second, mechanical filter, what kind of filter we use? Biological filter, I will explain a bit deeply in this topic. And degasser, which is a very important topic, and oxygen enrichment, and last one is the disinfection, UV disinfection, but also including the ozone disinfection as well. Okay, let me move. This is the basic the system of the RAS before we move to the tank. As you see, what I explained is by the schema. This is the tank, this is the filter, mechanical filter. Sometimes we use the protein skimmer if you use the seawater. This is the biofilter. And if you need the heating and cooling, you can use that kind of the equipment. And depend on your design, this filter can put here or before this area, depending. And UV system. This is a simple system. A research engine and some the demonstrative place can use this. The demonstrative aquaculture center in Trabzon has this system. We say the regular system, but I will explain also we have advanced one. So this is the one of the example of the advanced one for the big scale of the tank. You see the round shaped tank and the basic preparation of this one. Okay, this system, aquaculture system, important parameters should be measured, water and environmental condition. Because you cannot just think about the water. The environment is also very close with keep the constant temperature to reach your goal. So oxygen, water flow, light, temperature, salinity, carbon dioxide, stochastic density, feeding rate, and organic material and Last but not the least, the pH is the one of the important parameters. Okay, let's move to first the topic, fish tank. Depending on your aim, you can organize the different type of the tanks in your the RAS design, but it must be needs of the fish, needs the bottom dwelling species and pelagic, depend on the species. And water quality, depend on the tank design, size, shape, water depth, tank surface, and speed of water stream, self-cleanability is the one of the important the topic. Let's move to some example of the tanks. As you see, circulated tank is the wider the use in this area, but also the end raceway tank, depend on the, your species, it is the important, and raceway type. What is the difference between these three different tanks? As you see on the right side, there is a properties and advantages. Let's rating it to 1 to 5, which is the 5 is the best. Circulated tank, this one. The end raceway tank, that one. And raceway tank is the last one. Self-cleaning effect. Circulated tank is the best one. The other has a low residence time of the practice. This is the first one is the same as the self-cleaning. But oxygen control and regulation, there is no difference between this. The last one has a small, because on this corner, the water exchange cannot be the same as the other one. Fish utilization, it's the, one of the very important points for the design of RAS. This one is the high score. So the circulated tank. So when you're thinking to design your system, you can get some of the information from this table. You can see the, some different size and different type of the round shape tank in RAS system, hatchery, fish hatchery, sea bass or sea bass. You can see the big size of this one, very big. All over the world, this technique is the used commonly. This is the D-end raceway tank system. On the right side, the raceway system. Complete the tank, of course, depend on the tank. The construction material of the tank is also important, but it depends on the cost. Later on, our colleague mentioned about more deeply in all topics, explain to mechanical filtration. The aim of the mechanical filtration is the removal of suspended soil wash, SSV. So, when designing of the RAS or closing the mechanical filter, the wash loop and water that will be proceed must be considered. Otherwise, you cannot manage the RAS. It is crucial to remove wash from the system as quickly as possible. And manufacturing all that can occur in the mechanical filtration process will put more pressure on the next component of the RAS. This is important. Of course, depending on the design of the RAS, there are many options. There are many different type mechanical filtration. The automatic filtration or some, to remove to organic wash. You can see the some different type of this. There is a microstream filtration, drum filtration, and precise mechanical filtration also more recently start used in many places. Some filters and AFM filter is more recent, it's current technology. In our ADIS center, we used to the this one. I will show you. This is the drum filter, as you see. Sometimes the farm used this also outlet of the water for the open system. Micro screen filtration, drum filtration. You can see the more detail of this. So water is filtered through drum filters elements where solid are trapped and lifted the backwash area by the rotation of the drum. So I think our colleague will mention about more detail of this drum filter technology. Water from the rice nozzle is sprayed from the outside and of the filter elements. So it's a bit detailed. If you have some question, please write, we will answer to you. There is some detailed information. Of course, this all presentation will be published in, there are different type mechanical filter is the sun filters. And size also depend on your aim. More recently, precise mechanical filtration is the depend on the aim, but the people are try to this technique. In this precise system, a pump is used to deliver water under the pressure into the closed filter vessel. Inside the filter vessel, there are thick layer of the sand material or activated filter media. This is the important activated filter media. Water is filtered by the passing through to these layers. Benefits of the AFM filters, which is the more recent people are using this one. This media provide higher effective filtration surface than sand. The more precise material. AFM is a self-sterilizing media. It's important for the prevent the material. If it's sand, it's you need to clean it or change some certain time. There is a no bacteria one of the big problem for the sand filter is the biofouling. So in FMA the system, there is no kind of things. So there is no biocoagulation. This is a different type of the mechanical filter. One of the important component, and to manage the system, you need some expertise. This is the critical the filtration system. So the biofilter is the one of the important part of the RAS system. The biofilter's job is the removal of the water passed through the mechanical filter, such as dissolved component nitrogen, phosphate, and other small particles, naturally occurring to autotrophic bacteria colonized in the biomedia will break down nitrogenous waste. This process is the aerobic, and its success is dependent on temperature and pH. You must observe correctly, precisely temperature and pH. Even some the ammonium or the some, if your filtration doesn't work properly, it's dependent on the temperature and pH, you will be failed. So, what is your optimum level of the cultured fish for cultured fish? You must keep this temperature. Of course, pH depends on the other factor, but should be monitored the moderately. So, production of carbon dioxide and nitrogen as from nitrogen process affected pH levels. More issue about it. You can see the some nozzle, the material depend on the place you can reach. The aim of this material is the very simple. Improve the surface for bacteria. What kind of material you can reach, you can use. But the important thing is to improve the surface. Technically, biofilter work with some bacteria. Then nitrogen is toxic one. Free ammonia is toxic and needs to transform in the harmless nitrate. Bacteria do this, and I mentioned about you, nitrifying bacteria convert ammonia into nitrate and finally to nitrate. So this is the depend on the water temperature, pH level as well. You can see some different type of the biofilter. Sometimes you can see some the biofilter like this on the left side. You can see the open surface. But some the more recent is the closed one, and you can see the even open or closed, there is no problem. You can get the water. Of course, this is the inlet water for filtration, but the outlet of the your system, and supplied by air, water can go the surface on the deep of the tank. You can put the air and water together, and one of the easy way. Okay, biofilters are typically constructed using the plastic media giving high surface area per feet of the biofilter. I already showed some example of this. The bacteria will grow as a thin film on the media. They will be occupying an extremely large surface area. The most predominant identification bacteria is called Pseudomonas. To reach this Pseudomonas depend on your aim. You can buy it and add to your system, or you can open your system and work several weeks. It's occurred by themselves. The previous slide, maybe I need to say this one. There is a two way, fixed bed filters or moving bed filters. Your material can fix or move. So additionally, aeration, oxygenation, blowers or oxygen stones, tickle filters, diffused aeration system, whatever you can find, you can use this. Sterilization, I will explain. And sometimes you need some chemical buffering to for water permit. So let me explain degassing, which is a very important issue. Before the water runs back to tanks, you know, that it is the circulating, so accumulated gas must be removed. During this system, the stem accumulated some gases, which the fishes give the media. So carbon dioxide from the fish respiration and from the bacteria in the biofilter in the highest concentration. So you must remove this one. Free nitrogen also need to remove. Under the anaerobic condition, hydrogen sulfate can be produced, especially in seawater system, saltwater system. The gas is extremely toxic. There are different type of the system to remove the gas. The one of the best is aeration, by pumping air into water. Of course, there is another way, turbulent contact between the air bubbles to water, dry out the gas. The gas is the more efficient for removal gas as a trick. You can see the information and some the picture of the system. What fish need is oxygen. One of them is the oxygen. So this use the same water, the fish already use this oxygen, which the water has. So you must give extra oxygen in your system. Sufficient oxygen level for fish welfare is so important. So equilibrium of the oxygen in the water should be 100 saturation. When the water has been through the fish tank, the oxygen content has been lower, typically down to 70%, and content is reduced further in the biofilter. Aeration will typically bring the saturation up to around 90%, and in some system, at 100 can be reached. Of course, you can use also pure oxygen liquid form, is often lower in tanks, but can also be produced on the farm in an oxygen generator. There are typically two systems. High pressure oxygen pump system and low heat oxygen system, such as oxygen platform. On the first one, water and pure oxygen are mixed under the pressure. So in the oxygen, the press in the accomplished by a pump create a high pressure, like 1.4 bar. The low heat oxygen system, such as oxygen platforms, the pressure is much lower, around 0.1 bar. Water is simply pumped through the box, mixing water and oxygen. You can see the oxygen, the cone for dissolving poor oxygen and high pressure, and you can see the sun sensor substrate. So oxygen platform also, you can see to some enrichment the platform. Oxygen platform for poor oxygen at low pressure while pumping water around in the farms. There are different the systems. This is one of the examples. Of course, the disease management, one of the important topic, which is the advantage of the system, RAS system. But you must so careful about it. If you once you the somehow the some disease, some pathogen reach to your system, it's so difficult to eliminate it. So if any case, you need to use the UV disinfection in your system to eliminate any things. One of the role, how it's work, the UV destroy the DNA in biological organisms such as bacteria or virus. In aquaculture, we target the bacteria, but this is the 99%, not 100% protect your the fish, but a very high level protection. The treatment does not impact the fish because you treat the UV out of your reeling tank. Community mechanical filtering and biofilter to remove organic matter from the water provides efficient operation of the UV radiation. This is the, one of the important topics. If your mechanical filter doesn't work perfectly, properly, your your UV treatment system performance decreasing. It's clear. So both systems are work with together. If one of them is the work perfectly, properly, the other is also the increased their efficiency. So not only for UV sterilization, but also for oxygen, the ozone is the one of the important. This is the, some example what kind of the UV you can use to kill the some bacteria, virus, or fungi or small particles. This is the example of the system. You can depend on your ability. You can buy this system, or you can you can produce this system to buy the some lamp and material. You can just put some plastic and buy the lamp, so you can complete this. Depend on your skill. This is the closed system and open system. So one of the other way is the ozone disinfection. This is the critical one. Ozone treatment is an efficient way of destroying the unwanted organism by the heavy oxidation of organic matter and biological organisms. Microparticles are broken down into molecular structures that will bind together again and form larger particles. Overdosing can cause searing injury to fish, especially for small size, the larvae or fingerling. If your the dose is the higher than the what you arrange, it's really dangerous for your fish. You need proper ventilation and proper monitoring. Okay. So, in general, what is the advantage of the RAS? Let's summarize this issue. As I mentioned about the beginning, location flexibility. You can use this system wherever you can reach the electricity and places. So limited amount of water, just small amount of water enough to produce big amount of high volume fish. And you can make your farm or your, depending on your aim, you can establish your the RAS, the close to market. So harvest flexibility, species, and you can the culture different species, because you can improve the temperature, decrease the temperature, you can arrange temperature what fish need, what is the optimum temperature for fish culture. So it's the easy way to remove to nutrient. And you know, the more recently the impact of environment is one of the important topic. So discharge water is 90% decreasing. So this is one of the advantages of this issue. And this is, of course, environmentally friendly. External factors or water pollutants, it's the, more or less you eliminate this, because the, you know, the in many cases, if the water is polluted, the farm has a big problem. Sorry. Parameters are in control. You can arrange the temperature or others. This is under your control. So, as I mentioned it before, low chance of the infection due to the limited use of water. So, the your technician and aquaculturist, if they are careful, there is a very low the chance. and of course, it depends on the weather. But there is some disadvantage of the system because it needs some investment. It's a high investment per capita, and the operational cost is relatively high, and you need the constant monitoring. You cannot go there by once a week or once a 10 days. You must constant monitoring. And of course, you use to many the mechanical issues like pump or others. So sometimes it's there's some failures. So you need plan B, all case. Electrical reliability and problems. But the generator is the one of the solution, but of course is the one of the advantage of this thing. And one of the very important one, last one, is skilled management and technicians recovery is the most important one part of this. Because in all the countries, all places, you cannot find that kind of, but it's easy to improve their skills to educate. So we have some the on-site course in our the ADC center. Previously we have some culture method, but also this also could be give the some technician. So water treatment, test and monitoring, feeding technology, programming and waste treatment is so important to develop on RAS. Development of RAS typically focused on energy efficiency, biosecurity, plant management, particle control, optimizing on biological treatment, so biological water treatment. So this is the really important. Even the construction building is one of the important part of this system. If the isolation for temperature is very low, it's a problem for you. It means that you spend high the energy and high cost on the system. So some system is complicated, as you see. At the beginning, I will show you the simple one, but it's the complicated one. Let's move the other example. You see that this is the one of the complicated, small scale complicated one. This is they need some panel, electricity panel, different type of the panel. So this is the compact system. All the FMA filter is here. Heat exchanger filter, main filter, UV control panel, UV disinfection. This is the big one biofilter. This is the service platform. And of course, this is the protein skimmer, but this depends on the, if you use the fresh water, it's not necessary. Let's see the different type. Same, but different type. The aim is similar, but the design is the different. So on the left side, I showed at the beginning of my presentation, this is a simple one, which we have in Trabzon Center of Research Institute, ADC Center. On the right side, this is the complicated and modern one, which founded by GFCM and the area preparing the athletes co-founded the Center of Research Institute also paid the construction. And as you see, there's a big the salmon hatchery in Chile, 40 million smolt per year. Feeding capacity is the almost 10 ton by day. There is no river, no lake, nothing around here, but 40 million smolt per year in the United States, Canada, India. See, more close, let's look to more close. This is in Europe, the other system, law system, in Norway. Yeah, it's the The other one is also in, I think, in Norway. This system has a 3 million smolt per year, total 3,000 cubic meter. And you can see the Marine Harvest, which is the one of the biggest company for this. This is for 1 million smolt per year. This is some example in China for the flounder and turbot. And there is some the aquarium all over the world. So what I want to say in general is this: the recirculating aquaculture system and overview. We say the short the RAS. So you can find my presentation in the GFCM Secretariat in news. So you can see my email addresses. What I want to say is this, Matteo. Thank you to our colleague and our the friend watching this join us.